Hey, happy Wednesday, everybody. I'm sitting here with Brittany Talley, the head softball coach at Vernon College in Vernon, Texas this morning. So how you doing, Brittany? How's Vernon?
I'm good. We're good. There's zero cases here, so we're still on regular work schedule.
There you go. Well, awesome. Well, I'll turn it over to you and just kind of let you give the kids some pointers on what they can be doing right now during the coronavirus to, help recruiting. So I'll just be quiet and let you take it from here.
Okay. Okay, well, my points that I wanted to touch on was about keeping a routine during quarantine and expectations coming into college. Every year we face a lot of freshmen that get there and they're like, wow, I expected this, but I didn't expect it to be like this. So there's a big mental gap and a mental prep that you have to go through. Especially now because our summer is expanded. So generally, kids are going to have 2 to 2.5 months between their senior years and coming into college of travel ball preparation and then coming into the fall season and fall. If you're NCAA 45-day seasons or NAIA and JUCO, you have open training in the fall as far as I know. But now with this situation, even our college kids seasons have got canceled. So they're at home for, you guys are at home for 4.5 to almost 5 months before college is going to start, or school is going to start up again, high schools even, and fall training with your coaches. So it's really important that you guys work on keeping a routine, whether it's for mental health, physical health, all of those decisions, because you guys are used to interacting with your friends and your teammates every day. You're used to only seeing your families for, 2 hours a day right before you go to sleep, or being in your house right after practice, right after school for 45 minutes and then going to your room and ignoring the rest of your family. So it's a real different mental aspects if you're able to have access to anywhere that allows you to continue skills training, or finding creative ways to do it in and around your house, with your backyard, with your little brothers and sisters, if you're an only child with a wall. So some of the reasons that we encouraged our kids to keep a routine was to keep a muscle mass on themselves. We have a lot of girls that have already started losing weight, but they're continuing to try and run or do HIIT workouts or find things around the house, anything they can use to make weights. I had one girl use her little sister on her back for squats, probably not the healthiest option, but if whatever she could do to try and maintain her weight. This is going to be a different body adjustment. A lot of you guys think you're late nighters, and then you get to college and you realize, hey, I can't stay up until 2 anymore because I have to be up at 6 a.m. the next morning and I don't get to go to sleep until 9 p.m. the next night, which is a big comparison issue. You get to college and you think, I did this in high school, I did this in travel ball, and I was fine. College is a bit different, buds. You don't have your parents dictating your time schedule. You have to time management yourself. You have to learn how to study by yourself. You have to get up by yourself, go to bed by yourself. We encourage our girls to keep daily planners and to use different techniques as far as learning how to manage their own time and continue on their routes. Your diet is going to be really important during this. If you're snacking 20 times a day, you're not burning as many calories as you would during a school year or during a season or during a travel ball tournament. Our girls can burn anywhere from, 3,000 to 4,000 calories a day. And so we're having them replenish that during season. But now, you're laying around the house, you're helping mom out with chores, you're doing whatever is necessary. So you need to make sure that there's a balance there so that the weight you put on is good weight and you're not just developing poor eating habits while we're stuck in a house for however long amount of time that is dictated by the government. Whatever exercise you can get in, if there's stairs in your house, go up and down. if there's a yard you have and you can get outside and get some sun and do whatever you can do in the yard, then I highly encourage that. I live in an apartment complex, so I just walk the parking lot several times a day. We're allowed to be outside. All our tracks are closed, so our girls aren't allowed to go to the tracks, but they can get out in their neighborhoods and walk the streets with the social distancing compliance rules. So a lot of them have been engaged in that. A lot of colleges programs are going to have fitness tests when you get to school. So there's 5.5 months, you're going to have some type of preparation ready for that. I'm not saying that every coach adheres to that policy, but we do. And so we've strongly encouraged the girls to maintain some type of activity. Have you worked on your skills? If there's a wall, if you have a wall and a tennis ball, Walmart's open. You can go buy some tennis balls. Hopefully they're not all sold out since everybody wants to be outside now. If you can get some tennis balls and just throw it against the wall, bare hand drills are awesome. And we really don't want to come into August. We've talked about it with other coaches. It's going to be a different scenario if every college in America has, you know, students coming in August that haven't seen live pitching in 5 months. And if the fall season is to get canceled, then we're going to go into January without seeing live pitching for 8 to 9 months, which is going to be a whole nother animal once we encounter it. But so it's really important you're getting some type of work other than tee work and not creating yourself a tee monster. For baseball, softball, basketball, get some shots up. You know, track, you guys are good. You can do all your drills and exercises, whatever you need to do. And volleyball, you know, your best friend is the wall anyway, if you don't have a partner. So some expectations coming into college. I asked some of my previous athletes what they would recommend as advice for incoming freshmen. And their biggest thing was the not comparison rule. College is not going to be anything like travel ball or like high school. So make sure that your mental capabilities are geared towards, okay, it's a new environment, a new coaching system, new team, and I'm going to do everything I can to be part of that and buy into that. I got an analogy when I switched high schools. If you go into a new school and you think about them as boyfriends, so you're not going to go to your new boyfriend or girlfriend and say, well, me and my ex did this, and me and my ex did that, and me and my ex, and me and my ex, and me and my ex. So when you're going into college, you don't want to say, well, me and my high school, and me and my travel ball, me and my AAU team. You know, you want to be engaged and be moving forward into the college program, what the coaches have to say, what your teammates are, what is the culture? Are you going to buy in? Are you going to genuinely invest yourself in giving yourself an opportunity to love it? Or are you going to find every negative and then find yourself a way out? There's going to be lots of adversity in the classroom, in the field, on the court, whatever you can. It takes a whole lot of work to earn yourself a starting spot in any lineup. So are you willing to put in that work every day and maintain it and compete and keep going? The other one is not to care about recruits coming in or, you know, other people. Only care about them as teammates. You know what I mean? Your biggest competition is yourself. Did I get 1% better today in what everything that I had to do? Did I wake up right on time or did I get up 5 minutes earlier than I was supposed to? Did I get to class and pay attention or did I put my headphones in, my AirPods in, hide them under my hair and keep going doing whatever I felt like I needed to do that day? Did I get all my work done prior to practice or am I going to stay up until 2 a.m. cramming an all-nighter because I had poor time management skills? So what can I do? With the quarantine, it's really easy now to establish a functional daily routine and start trying to maintain yourself on that. And so that you can continue and carry that into your experience, whether you're a freshman, sophomore, junior in high school and you're going into a new high school year or you're going into college. So make yourself some to-do lists. I get a lot of satisfaction off of crossing things off of my to-do list once they're done. Not everybody gets that satisfaction, but I do. So if it works for you, then to-do lists are awesome. And write it down. Don't put it in your phone and check it off. Physically write it down so that you remember it three ways. You've read it, you've wrote it, and you're remembering it. Make designated time slots. If you find yourself like struggling with routine, say, I'm going to exercise every day from 11 to 12, and then I know I can eat lunch right after. So your motivation is to get back to lunch. Food is a huge motivation for all of my athletes. So I know that if we say like, hey, if we do this, we're going to such and such place for dinner, all of a sudden it jumps up and gets done. So give yourself designated time slots. While we have lots and lots of time to do everything and nothing at the same time, no multitasking. I know it sounds really difficult. As a woman, it's really hard for me, but I know that I have lots of time to get everything done. So I try and focus on one task at a time or at least give that task 45 minutes before moving on to another task. I try not to tackle two tasks at one time. this isn't something you might be able to do once the school year starts up again, but right now you have a lot of time, especially with online schoolwork, and then trying to build in exercise and routines. So this will all work. Say if I wake up at 9 a.m. every day and I do my schoolwork from 9 to 11, and then I know I'm going to exercise from 11 to 12, and then I have lunch, and then I have the whole afternoon to kind of just chill out, do what I need to do, or I can get outside and get some skill work in my designated sport, and find something you enjoy to do on that off time. So if you get your schoolwork done first and get it out of the way, then you don't have to worry about it for the rest of the day. You know, most homeschool teachers and parents have recommended even no more than 2 to 4 hours of schoolwork a day. So, you know, with that being said, you don't have to be doing your schoolwork all 8 hours that you would be in class, because there may not be that much, or your brain doesn't function the same at home. Another tip that I give my kids is not to do their homework in bed. Not to do anything in your bed, but get ready to go to sleep, because then your brain starts functioning as my bed is a workplace. It's not really a place of rest. It's not a place of sleep. I'm not going to be able to shut my body down and relax if I'm used to doing other things in my bed. I know that sounds crazy. You're probably thinking, this old lady, she just wants to go to bed. But it's really, your brain picks up on different activities that you do in different places, and it starts to associate those places with that work. So if you lay on your bed and, you know, play on your phone all the time, every time you lay down, you're going to probably reach for your phone, not out of habit, but out of associating that bed with that phone. So make sure you keep that. More in preparation for coming into college, reach out to, and when you're going on visits, try and reach out to the current players. Ask them all kinds of questions, get their social media accounts, get their personal numbers, you know, if you feel like you had a vibe or a connection with them, so that you can ask questions that you may not ask a coach, or you may not ask when a coach is present. I tell everybody, you know, my girls aren't going to sugarcoat for me. They want girls who are going to come in and buy into the culture and be a part of their team and what they've helped build and establish. So they're not going to lie and tell you what you want to hear. They're going to tell you what it is when you're coming to Vernon College. So make sure that you get those connections and you get those access to ask those questions that you want to know, because if you don't like running, you don't want to go to a program that runs a lot. If you don't, you're not a big power hitter and that's all they have in their lineup currently, then it may not be a great fit for you. You know, same thing, basketball, volleyball, track, try and reach out to current athletes that are part of the program, so you understand what it is coming in. What is their daily schedule? You can listen and say, oh, you know, that's kind of what I do now, but what is it really like? What do their bodies feel like at the end of the day? Are they mentally drained? Are they mentally exhausted? What was the biggest difference they felt? If they're a transfer, why did they transfer into this program versus their last program? And did you listen to them, and are you fully prepared going into there? That is the biggest thing, I think, is knowing 100% what to expect when you're coming into a program and being willing to buy into those things. The academics are going to be tough, I feel like, no matter where you're at. We're at a JUCO, and our girls have to work really hard every day on their academics as well as their sporting stuff. Different organizations and different leagues have different time constraints on practice times, but that doesn't stop you from doing what you want to do as an individual. So it's all about how you can handle it and how you can keep going. And any other questions, you guys can shoot me an email or shoot me a social media. You can find me on Twitter at Coach B Tally, and my Instagram is the same, at Coach B Tally. We're open. All of my previous players and myself, we answer questions frequently. I'm really big on making sure that athletes that come into college know exactly what they're getting and know the time commitments and the physical commitments that it's going to entail. So thank you guys for paying attention, and we'll see you guys later.
All right. Thanks, Brittany. Have a great day. Thanks.